Week two of the high school football season is here, and that means some big matchups that we're not so used to seeing. Kapolei was in a defensive battle with Kamehameha. Let's start with a two-time defending state champ St. Louis, playing Waianae at Aloha Stadium, who's hoping to rebound from an upset last week. Before the offense stepped onto the field, first pass of the game, Corvin Fagan's interception returned for a touchdown. Fagan, starting for the first time this season, takes it to the house. And then what everyone wants to see, Jaden Delora, the heir apparent for St. Louis at QB. First drive, scrambling. He already has an offer from UH, and the sophomore looks comfortable in the Hawaii end zone. Got the first running score, and the next drive gave us the first passing touchdown. Delora was 9 for 13 with 229 yards, three touchdowns in just the first half. At last check, Crusaders led 48-6. To the early game now, Kamehameha and Kapolei. Didn't start well for the Canes. The Warriors UH commit, Tiger Peterson snags the interception, one of two Warriors interceptions. The first half was defense heavy. The biggest offensive play came here in a connection from Tanuvasa Moe to Skylar Ramos, but the Hurricanes, they made a push out of halftime. Sophomore backup quarterback Noah Bailey had to enter early in the game when the starter was injured. His best pass of the day goes over the middle for a 52-yard score. The Warriors scored two touchdowns late, though. In the fourth, they win 21-7. Out to Radford now, where the Damien was opening its season on the road against the Rams, who were looking for win number one on the season. The Monarchs' Jake Holtz gets sacked by the Rams' pass rush right there, and then later on, Holtz, he's going to air it out. Watch this play. It would eventually be called back because of a penalty, but Holtz, he did toss for two touchdowns so far in this game. At last check, the Monarchs, they led 28-0 late in the fourth quarter. Over to Farrington now, high school. That's the field they're playing, but it was Kalani and Kaimuki. This one was a blowout in favor of the Bulldogs. A running clock, and as it was almost expiring, Antrone Cliff Jr. takes around the edge for a touchdown. He's excited. Kaimuki wins 49-0, the final there.